So the question today and the topic today is, how do blood sugar spikes affect Hashimoto's? So there's like 42 different triggers for Hashimoto's. I think maybe 43 now, but there's a lot of triggers. And one of them is dysglycemia. Dysglycemia means your blood sugar goes up and down. If you're diabetic, your blood sugar goes up and pretty much stays up. If you're severely hypoglycemic, your blood sugar goes down. Usually, like if on your labs, your glucose is below 60, 65, 70, depends on what lab you're going to, your blood sugar is pretty much going to stay low. But if you're in between those, if you're on your way to high blood sugar, or if you're on your way to low blood sugar, you don't know it, you're not getting it checked, you're not doing anything about it. Before you hit diabetes, before you hit total clinical hypoglycemia, your blood sugar goes up and down between high and low blood sugar. The terms for those are insulin resistance, prediabetes, and reactive hypoglycemia. So you're going like this. If you think you have that, the two main symptoms to look and see if you have is fatigue after meals, is usually insulin resistance. Not always, sometimes it can be other things. But if you have that and then you have eating release fatigue, those two questions, and if you have both of those, your blood sugar is probably going up and down, up and down, up and down. Okay, so how does that affect Hashimoto's? It's actually pretty basic. It's actually pretty simple explanation. When your blood sugar goes up, it increases something called cortisol. Most of my patients know cortisol as a stress hormone because everybody's stressed today and everybody's looked on the internet to see what's happening. And so, but cortisol is primarily considered a glucocorticoid, meaning that it's a steroid that controls your blood sugar. So when your blood sugar goes up, cortisol goes up. And when your blood sugar goes down, cortisol goes down, and vice versa. So if cortisol goes down, your blood sugar goes down. If cortisol goes up, your blood sugar goes up. Cortisol also is a hormone that has a player. It's an early player in inflammatory processes. But when cortisol goes up, it's inflammatory. When cortisol goes down, it's inflammatory. And so inflammation triggers immune responses. Hashimoto's is an autoimmune problem. You have so many triggers. In the end, I have a massage therapist who says, well, Dr. Rutherford, isn't it all about inflammation? And just don't you just give them turmeric? I'm like, well, if you give my patients turmeric, it's going to be like peeing on a forest fire. They're going to get like no reaction whatsoever. You have to figure out all of the triggers and take away all of the triggers that are causing inflammation. If you have a bunch of them, you have to take a bunch of them away. Dysglycemia is up there as far as one of the more one of the stronger triggers for autoimmune thyroid disease. I mean, I put way up there. I mean, if there was 42 or 43 of them, I think I would put it in the top five or six maybe, because we don't control our blood sugar very well. If you don't eat frequently enough, you may not be controlling it. If you eat junk, you may not be controlling it. If you don't eat enough, you're not controlling it. If you eat too much, you're not controlling it. We don't really have a sense of that in today's society because we have food everywhere all the time. We're walking around, we just grab it, we eat. You know, some people need to do snacks in between, other people that's not good for, and so on and so forth. So blood sugar is depending on all, and stress. Stress goes up, stress causes insulin to go up, blood sugar goes up, inflammation occurs, boom, that'll affect your Hashimoto's. That'll cause all of these inflammatory responses, cause your antibodies, your TPO antibodies to go up, and then that creates more thyroid hormone, and then that causes an attack on your thyroid. I mean, that goes up, attacks your thyroid, and then that causes more thyroid hormone, and then you get jittery and shaky and those types of things. So it's a big one. It's actually a big one. It's a good question. It really is. You know, if I have patients that come in, another one is low blood pressure. If I have people come in, they have low blood pressure and they have poor blood sugar, their neurons, their brains, their cells are not getting oxygen from the low blood pressure. And their cells are getting chronic inflammation from blood sugar going up. That's a hard person to fix if you don't fix those two things first. You can take the gluten away and you can do the all the other things, but if those two things keep going like that, tough case. So you have to treat that in addition to treating all those other things. So that's how blood sugar affects Hashimoto's.